Good morning, everyone. Today is Saturday. I have a couple things planned for today. First things first, I need to eat. And then secondly, I'm gonna be on a mission today to transform my apartment to Christmas from now what is fall. It's gonna be fun, and I love this time of year because I love decorating my apartment for the different seasons and holidays. So yeah, keep watching. Santa, tell me if you're really there. Don't make me fall in love again if you won't be here next year. Santa, tell me if he really cares. Cause I can't give it all away if he won't be here next year. Feeling Christmas all around, and I'm trying to play it cool, but it's hard to focus when I see him walking across the room. Let it snow is blasting. It's a little later in the evening and we just finished putting up the Christmas decorations. I hope you enjoyed that little segment, but the plan now is to go to the gym and hit back, and then afterwards run to the grocery store to get some last minute items for my meal prep this week. I'm gonna be taking you guys along with me to the gym, so here we go. I'll see you when I get there. I'll be starting out my workout today with some bike sprints. I normally just cruise for a little bit and then hop right on into the high intensity pedaling. I will pedal in intervals of anywhere between 25 to 30 seconds, and I will do this a total of 5 times. I always make sure that I do a 2-minute recovery in between each sprint, and I normally like to stay at a gear of around 8 to 10. Once I'm finished sprinting, I will stand up on the bike and kick up my resistance to around 13 to 14. I stand up on the bike and try to control my leg movements. I have noticed that the slower you pedal and the less you move your upper body to concentrate more on your legs, the more immense burn you'll feel in your quads and your hamstrings. I'll normally stay in this position and at this gear for about 5 minutes as kind of an ending to my cardio. I decided to start my back workout with some straight arm cable pull downs. I set the weight to around 32 and stayed there for all four sets. I just always make sure that I'm focusing on my lats, and in order to do this, you just want to keep your arms as straight as possible and slightly bent at your hips and lean forward. For this next exercise, I decided to do the two-arm cable row. I did something very similar in my last back video, except I was in the kneeling position. I do about four sets of these and try to squeeze in anywhere between 8 to 10 reps per set. I'll start out at around 40 pounds and then work my way up 10 pounds per set afterwards. So for my third back movement, I will be doing your standard lat pull downs. I try to do anywhere between 4 to 5 sets of these and squeeze in 10 to 12 reps per set. And while I'm still in the same machine, I'll just switch out the wide grip bar for a closed grip bar and do closed grip pull downs with the same weight that I was doing the lat pull downs with. When doing this exercise, I just make sure that my movements are controlled and that when my elbows are brought down, I'm really squeezing my back muscles. For the third movement on this same machine, I will be doing reverse lat pull downs. When you are doing these pull downs, you want to make sure that your hands are turned in a way that your palms are facing you and the grip is a lot closer together than the standard pull down. Next up, I'll just be doing some low rows. I will do four sets of these. I'll start out at 45 pounds and then add on 5 pounds to each set that I do. For my fourth set on these rows, I'll max out at around 60 pounds. While on the same machine, I'm just gonna switch out the closed bar grip to a wide bar grip. I think that it's important when you're in the gym to be efficient. Get creative and just think of ways to hit all of your movements without necessarily having to use every single machine in the gym. I decided to end my workout with some face pulls. I find it easiest to squat during face pulls because it helps a lot with the overall balance. So as you can see here, I'm just pulling back, getting the rope as close to my face as I can, and then squeezing. Okay, so grocery store fail. I left my cell phone in the car and it has my grocery list on it. So now I'm going straight off of memory, so we'll see how I do. Hey guys, so just got back in the car from the grocery store, getting gas now. Like I mentioned, I had forgotten my phone in the car, which had my grocery list on it. Super annoying, hate when I do that, but I did really well actually. I only forgot one item, and it was my Theraflu. I've just been kind of feeling like under the weather since yesterday. My throat's really starting to get itchy, and I'm traveling next weekend, so I'm trying to avoid getting sick at all costs, which is not something that I want to deal with. And then like on top of like the holiday like crowds, not feeling it. So the plan is to go home, shower, and then try to prep as much as I can for this week as far as like meal preps and stuff, and then get some sleep.